Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Mangesh Vaghmare, working as Assistant Professor in Siyagad Institute of Technology, Lonavala. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate a diffraction grating experiment. The aim of this experiment is to determine the wavelength of light using diffraction grating. Now let's quickly discuss the apparatus required to perform this experiment. This is a mercury vapor lamp, white source. This is a spectrometer. Then to perform this experiment we require grating. So this is a diffraction grating. Then in order to level this spectrometer, we require spirit level. And as we are going to perform this experiment in a dark room, we require a magnifying glass to record the readings, and a table lamp is required. So with the help of a magnifying glass and a table lamp, we are going to record readings in dark. So this is all about the experimental setup. Now we'll quickly discuss the theory part. Now aim of this experiment is to determine the wavelength of light of the given source. Now this is one of the basic tasks in spectroscopy, to determine the wavelength of different spectral lines. Now this experiment is based on diffraction of light. Diffraction is nothing but bending of light around the corners or around the edges of a diffracting element or an obstacle, and they're spreading into the geometrical shadow of that obstacle. Now this is a spectrometer. Now what do you mean by spectrometer? What is use of the spectrometer? Now spectrometer, this is an optical instrument which is used to produce, to observe and to analyze spectral lines. Then there are different parts of this spectrometer which are important in order to handle this particular optical instrument. Now this is a collimator. This is adjustable slit. This is adjustable slit. If you rotate this screw, you can see we can adjust width of the slit. This is maximum, and when we rotate this in other direction, as you can see, the width is decreasing. So we can adjust width of the slit. That's why this is called as adjustable slit arrangement. Now this is a focusing screw. Then this is a prism table. You can call it as a prism table or a grating table. And this is a telescope. Now when we rotate telescope, the scale which is rotating is a main scale in this case. And there are two windows, as you can see. This is window 1, window 2. Or you can call this as there are two vernier scales. This is vernier scale 1, vernier scale 2. Okay, I repeat. The scale which is rotating, when you rotate this telescope, the scale which is rotating is a main scale. Then there is a one fixed scale, it's called a vernier scale. Now these are two scales are important in order to calculate least count of this optical instrument. Now collimator is used to obtain parallel beam of light. Then to mount the grating, we are going to use this particular arrangement. And to after diffraction, we are going to observe a spectrum consisting of different colors. To observe that pattern, we are going to use this telescope. This is the diffraction grating. Now what do you mean by grating? Now grating is an arrangement consisting of equidistant parallel slits. Now how the grating is prepared? So it is prepared by ruling equidistant lines on glass plate with the help of diamond pointer. Now the line drawn on glass, it acts as opaque region, and then the distance between two lines will be a slit. Means the slit is formed by ruling lines on this glass plate. So there are number of equidistant parallel slit. This is the ray diagram of this particular experiment. Now in this ray diagram, we'll quickly understand the different blocks. As you can see in the diagram, now this is a mercury vapor lamp. This is a white source. Then this is a collimator in order to obtain parallel light. Then this is a DG, is a diffraction grating, and T is a telescope. Now, as you can see, we are going to observe after diffraction, when a light will incident on this diffracting grating, light will get diffracted, and the diffraction pattern consisting of different colors will be observed on right side as well as on left side. When telescope is on right, you are going to observe the diffraction pattern consisting of colors, means vibrio will be observed, that is violet to red, and the same pattern will be observed on the other side. Now, before the experiment, certain arrangements which are important. The first one is a leveling of this spectrometer. So with the help of this spirit level, you need to make sure the bubble is at the center. Okay, so you need to make sure the horizontal arrangement of this spectrometer. So you need to place this spirit level on this prism table as well as on telescope, then collimator, to make sure all these parts, means telescope is horizontal, a collimator is horizontal, and this prism table is horizontal. If not, so if there are screws provided, with the help of these screws you will make sure the bubble of that spirit level is at the center. In this way, you need to level the instrument first of all. After that, one more arrangement is very, very important, that is a Schuster method. And that Schuster method, that arrangement is important, and that arrangement you need to do for parallel light. So you need to adjust collimator and telescope for parallel rays with the help of that Schuster method. So once the everything is set, and after that we are going to place this grating. Now you need to mount this grating on this grating table in such a manner that the plane of this grating is perpendicular to the grating table, and also the face of this grating should be perpendicular. It should lie perpendicular, normal to this collimator. Okay, so once everything is set, after that you will observe the diffraction pattern consisting of different colors. Means you will observe the diffraction pattern on right-hand side, and the same pattern consisting of different colors on left-hand side. So this is all about the experimental arrangement of diffraction grating. Now, how to record angle of diffraction? Now see here. Now in this optical instrument, see, there are two scales. When we rotate telescope, the scale which is rotating is main, and the scale which is fixed is vernier. The scale which is rotating is main scale, and the scale which is fixed is vernier. And as you can see, there are 30 divisions on vernier. In diffraction grating, the diffraction pattern consisting of different spectral lines. And whenever we observe any spectral line, nothing but principal maximum of that particular spectral line. Now, what is the condition to observe principal maximum? The condition to observe principal maximum is A plus B sine theta is equal to M lambda. Now, what is A plus B? A plus B is a grating element. Theta is angle of diffraction. M is order of diffraction. And lambda is wavelength of light. For example, if you are observing green color, so lambda will be wavelength of green color and theta will be angle of diffraction for green. Now, as we are going to observe first order diffraction pattern, therefore this order of diffraction will be 1. So the formula becomes lambda is equal to A plus B sine theta. Now, the A plus B is a grating element. Now, how will you calculate grating element? Now, in the grating which we are using, on this grating, the number of slits are mentioned. That number is mentioned. So, there are 15,000 lines per inch. So, with the help of this particular number, we can calculate grating element.
A grating element, it is simply the spacing between adjacent slits, is a reciprocal of number of lines. So capital N, number of lines on the grating. Now in this case, capital N is 15,000. Therefore, grating element A plus B, now if you want to calculate in centimeters, 2.54 divided by 15,000. So we get that value as 1.69333 into 10 raised to minus 4 centimeters. Now in Armstrong unit, if you convert that, 16933.33 Armstrong unit. So this particular value will be fixed. Means if you want to calculate wavelength of green, so the formula becomes lambda g A plus B sine theta. So A plus B we have already calculated. You will substitute that. Only thing is you should know angle of diffraction for green color. Then if you want to calculate wavelength of yellow, this number will be fixed. You supposed to just measure angle of diffraction for yellow, then red. So with the help of a spectrometer, simply by measuring angle of diffraction of different wavelengths, you'll be able to calculate wavelength of that particular color. Now we'll quickly understand how we're supposed to record all the readings. As we know, every instrument has least count. So before recording readings, you should know least count of this optical instrument. As we have already discussed, there are two windows and there are two scales. Now when we rotate telescope, the scale which is rotating is main scale and the fixed scale is vernier. And on the vernier scale, there are 30 divisions. Now how do we calculate least count? Least count is equal to value of the smallest division on the main scale divided by total number of divisions on the vernier scale. Now as we know, main scale readings are in degrees and value of the smallest division is 0.5 degree divided by total number of divisions on the vernier scale. There are 30 divisions. So 0.5 degree means 30 minutes divided by 30 divisions. So when we rearrange this, we get 1 minute. So least count of this optical instrument is 1 minute. Now let's quickly discuss how to record a total reading. So this formula we are going to use. Now in order to record total reading, main scale and vernier scale, these two scales are important. Now how to record main scale reading? To record main scale reading, you need to keep your eye on vernier scale 0. You need to see where this 0 coincides. This 0 will give you main scale reading. Now if it exactly coincides that particular division on the main scale, you will record that, but if it is in between, you will record a lower value. Now if we take this particular case, now this vernier scale 0 is in between 124.5 degree and 125 degree. So even if it is very close to 125 degree, we are not going to record that. It is in between, so we'll record a lower value. So our MSR is 124.5 degree. After that, there are 30 divisions on the vernier scale. Now out of 30 divisions on the vernier scale, which division is exactly matching with the main scale? That particular number means you will start from first, second, third, fourth. Out of 30 divisions, which is exactly coinciding with main scale, which is exactly matching with main scale division, that particular number will be your VSR. Now in this particular case, this particular line is exactly matching. So that number we need to record. So that number is, if we start from this particular point, first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, 10th, 11th, 12th, 13th, 14th. Now if 14th division is exactly matching, so 14 you will write multiplied by least count, we have already recorded, that is 1 minute. So the total reading will be 124.5 degree plus, now this is 14 minutes. Now you will convert 14 minutes into degrees. Now how will you convert that? So 14 divided by 60, this will be degree. So 124.5 degree plus 0.233 degree. So if we add VSR value, so it comes around 124.73 degree. So this is our total reading. So this is how you're supposed to record readings for different spectral lines. Now the instrument is set to record all the readings. We already mounted grating. Now when collimator is in line with telescope, you will observe direct image of the slit. We are going to take that particular image as a reference line. Then you will observe pattern on right side of that particular reference line, and the same pattern you will observe on left. Now when telescope is on right, and when we record reading for green, yellow, red, we'll enter those readings in right column, because if you see the observation table, there are two columns, right and left. So when telescope is on right, you will enter those readings in that particular column, and when telescope is on left, you will record a reading for different colors and you will enter reading in left column. Now when collimator is in line with telescope, we'll observe direct image of the slit. I'll show you that. Now I have adjusted vertical cross wire of the eyepiece on that white sharp line. You can see the direct image of the slit. Just now we have seen the direct image of the slit. Now looking through the eyepiece, if I rotate this to right side of the grating, we can observe a first order diffraction pattern consisting of different colors, nothing but spectral lines. Now I have rotated the telescope and I have adjusted vertical crosswire of the eyepiece on green color. We can see the pattern. You can see the different spectral lines. This is the diffraction pattern consisting of different spectral lines. But I have adjusted the vertical crosswire of the eyepiece on green color. Now as you can see different colors, but we are going to determine the wavelength of only three colors, green, yellow and red. We are going to determine the wavelength of only three colors, green, yellow and red. Now the telescope is on right side of the reference line. As you can see in this observation table, there are different columns, color of spectral line, green, yellow, red, angular position, left theta 1, right theta 2 in degrees. then 2 theta will be the difference between these two readings. Then we'll calculate theta, that is angle of diffraction, then sine of that, and then we'll substitute in the formula which we have discussed earlier. Now, one thing you need to remember is that as there are two windows, but you are going to record the readings on any one of the windows throughout your experiment. Okay. So you will record all the readings on either window 1 or on window 2, despite of the position of the telescope, whether it is on right or left, you will record a reading on the same window. Now I have adjusted vertical crosswire of the eyepiece on green color, so we'll record reading for that particular color. Now we'll record reading on window 1. Now as you can see, the reference 0, the vernier scale's 0 is in between 181 degree and 181.5. Now it is very close to 181.5 degree, but in that case we'll record a lower value, that is 181 degree. Now with the help of a magnifying glass and table lamp, very carefully you suppose to record the value of MSR as well as VSR. So with the help of magnifying lens and this table lamp, very carefully you suppose to record first of all MSR reading and then VSR. Now in this case MSR is 181 degree and the VSR value is 20. So the total reading will be, if we substitute that, we'll record the total reading as, the total reading in this case we have discussed earlier, total reading is equal to MSR value, that is 181 degree, and VSR is 20 multiplied by least count 1 minute. Now 181 degree plus, you will convert minutes into degrees, so 20 divided by 60, so this will be in degrees. So the total reading will be 20 divided by 60, so that is a 0.33 degrees. So our final reading will be 181.33 degree. Now we have recorded the reading for green color when telescope was on right, and we have got that value as 181.33 degree. Similarly, you will record reading for yellow, then for red, and then you will rotate the telescope on the other side. Again, you will follow the same sequence. You will record reading for green, yellow, red. Now, once we get theta 1, theta 2, very easily we'll calculate 2 theta. Once we get 2 theta from that, you will calculate theta, that is angle of diffraction for that particular wavelength. Then sine of theta, and then you will substitute that value in our formula, lambda is equal to a plus b sine theta. When we substitute all, we'll get wavelength of that particular spectral line. So in this way, very easily you can calculate wavelength of green, yellow and red. So in this way, very systematically we have discussed experimental setup of diffraction grating as well as how you supposed to record all the readings. I hope you would have understood all these points.